It's all about Haus and Home. Yeah, yeah. We care about improving lifestyles. It's all about the betterment for your life with Haus and Home. Yeah, it's all about the betterment.
Greetings everyone and welcome to another fantastic edition of Haus Home. I'm Theresa Miria. Thank you for joining me. What a long, awesome weekend. If you can recall, I mentioned something about church Easter camps, normal picnics, sports programs, and a little bit about school holidays in the last episode. Well, it all happened. My house was empty and quiet, I must say. All the kids went for Easter camp and I had the chance to make some music and sleep soundly. My weekend was epic despite several hiccups. All in all, it was epic. And I hope you all have enjoyed your long weekend as well. Obviously, Facebook was flooded with triumphant posts about Easter and a successful day out with friends and family. That is great news. Now back to our show. We have a great lineup and I can't wait to see what Nicole is preparing on Easy Meals. So let's see how she demonstrates the easy to make mozzarella, red capsicum and bacon skewers. Enjoy.
I am the black in the book, the letters on the pages that you memorize. And I am the orange in the
everyone, and welcome to Easy Meals. Once again, I'm here at Kokoda Trail Hotel. This time using the outdoor facilities, you can see a beautiful picnic area and we're using one of the house wings. So whenever you're up here, why not come check out the barbecue areas and also the picnic areas, grass for the kids to play. Now, when you're out on a picnic, there are certain things that you'd like to take for your family. Well, for now, I'm going to show you a simple recipe that you can use, and it's for those who just want to have fun with cooking. But this time, you don't cook anything except the bacon that you can preheat in your oven and bring it along. And yeah, that's how it's going to go. So right now we have just a few ingredients. We have olive oil in a bottle at the moment. You can use the pure one or the extract. Ground pepper. You can either use basil leaves or spinach. You can use the red capsicum or the yellow capsicum. It's all up to you. And mozzarella cheese. I have a bar here that I'll cut up into little cubes. So let's start. First of all, you will need to chop up your mozzarella cheese. Oh, and always remember when you're outdoors, either have a hand sanitizer or keep your hands clean when you're outdoors. So I've already done that. I'll just put it to the side. Get your kids to always sanitize their hands before they start eating. Oh, and also you will need some toothpicks, depending on how many mozzarella balls you'd like to make. So the simple picnic recipe is called the mozzarella, red capsicum, bacon skewers. So this is how we're going to start. First of all, our mozzarella cheese, let's cut it into cubes. Depend on the sizes that you'd like to cut them, you can do so. I will cut them into little cubes. I'll cut them up into little cubes that I can roll with the spinach and the bacon. So let's cut some more pieces up here. Some of this. Right now you can see that we have about 13 cubes of mozzarella cheese cut. Now we're gonna pull out our bacon. Had to wrap it up because place it there. Move your cheese to the side. The next thing to chop up is your capsicum. You can get them clean earlier on before you bring them, or you can do that on location. And then slice them up depending on the sizes that you prefer. And I will show you how to do this. So pick up your cheese, get a piece of your bacon, remove the outer layers. And then you're gonna roll your bacon, your cheese, your capsicum, and your spinach. So let's roll the first one. So you roll your bacon up. Then how many leaves of spinach you'd like to put in? The next thing will be your capsicum. So once it's like that, use your skewers to push it in from this end. It's nice and soft, so you can push it all the way to the other side and you will have the look. It's something that you can pack up in your lunchbox. So let's carry on with the rest of these remaining ingredients and I'll show you how to roll them up. Using your skewers, glamour and fashion models in magazines. A striking one-way entrance. From one side, there you have it. Roll it up. I lived in Denver. I met a millionaire with ribbons in her blonde hair. And I still remember she was like a princess straight from a dreamy. And capsicums, this you can find at your local markets. I got these ones at Malaro. We have some more to roll, so let's keep rolling. Your spinach. Skewers. Okay. Alright, now once you roll them up, you can get your clean plate and place them properly like that. See how colorful it looks? Something simple to do for your picnic outing or for barbecues. You can get your kids to help you as well. Just bacon, capsicum, mozzarella cheese, and some spinach or basil leaves if you have any. So once you have prepared your meal, place it like that. Get your ground pepper and then you can just sprinkle a bit on. Your olive oil, a bit of it, you can pour it on your lid and then just to sprinkle on it like that. There you have it, it's a simple picnic dish, mozzarella, red capsicum, and bacon skewers. Something simple that you can try out and have fun.
That was a very simple recipe, the mozzarella, red capsicum and bacon skewers. Viewers, this can be done in less than 10 minutes and if you're preparing for the whole family, you're looking at 10 to 20 minutes approximately. Nicole, that looked very delicious. I wonder what she has for next week. We take our first break, but stay where you are as we have Shopping with Brandbell featuring the customer credit scheme and some Mother's Day gift ideas along with a quick review on Mother's Choice competition. See you soon. Welcome back. Now with Mother's Day happening in the next month, Brandbell's customer credit scheme is a great way to get products according to your liking, specifically on credit basis. That's what the scheme is really all about. That is a huge advantage with simple benefits that can be of great help. So why don't we check out this amazing package that Brian Bell is showcasing in a bit. Enjoy and make sure to get as much information as you possibly can.
Hey, hey, Mr. B.
Hi there and welcome to another Shopping with Brian Bell. I'm your host, Leon Gowie. In this segment, we'll take a look at Brian Bell's Customer Credit, or CCS. This is a great way for you to get quality products and pay over a period of time with affordable installments. We'll also see how this is beneficial to you and how this can help you through this Mother's Day period in 2017. So let's get into it.
Brian Bell's Customer Credit, or CCS, is a great way for you to get products from Brian Bell on credit basis. CCS gives you the option to get your products now and pay in installments over a period of time. The simple benefits include, you get quality products, repayment is done over a period of time, and you won't break your budget. This will actually fit well into your fortnight.
Brian Bell's Customer Credit Scheme is a great way for you to get quality products from Brian Bell. But before you get these products, you must be eligible. To be eligible, you have to have your company registered with Brian Bell CCS. Also, you have to work for a minimum of 3 years, and you have to be a full-time worker. Part-time and casual workers are not eligible.
After that has been satisfied, these are the requirements our CCS team needs from you.
Now, here are the requirements that we need from you. Firstly, you need 3 recent payslips. Secondly, you need your identification or copies of your identification, maybe your driver's license or your employment ID. Thirdly, a letter of confirmation of employment from your employer, confirming the date of employment, your remuneration package, net pay, and so on and so forth. And finally, a quotation for the goods that you'd like to get from us or the retail outlets that we support here, for example, Kino. It's important that you realize that the quotes that you get last for only 14 days. So come on in, get a quote. This is a really simple process. Be a part of it. Now, the last step after you've fulfilled the requirements or satisfied the requirements is we're moving on to the customer credit scheme policies. Our policies are
customer credit scheme policy. There is no deposit required. Minimum accumulated purchase value is 300 kina and can comprise from any items from Brian Bell or partner organizations. Maximum purchase value is determined by the applicant's long service leave entitlements and net pay. Multiple quotes are permitted subject to applicant's eligibility. Minimum repayment term is 13 fortnights or 6 months, and the maximum repayment term is 26 fortnights or 1 year. Applicant CCS deductions must not exceed 50% of net pay. Total CCS purchase value including term charges must not exceed 50% of the applicant's long service leave entitlements. First deductions must commence before items are collected or delivered. Cash payments in lieu of the first deduction is not permitted. Applicants must provide evidence of first deduction, meaning payslip prior to collection or delivery of items.
Our CCS teams are located nationwide in all our home centers. That's right, you heard me right. It's nationwide in all 8 of our home centers. Kokopo, Medang, Leh, Gorka, Mount Hagen, Gordons, Brian Bell Plaza, Boroko, and Vision City. So come on in and check it out. Our Mother's Choice competition is also up and running as of yesterday, the 17th of April. So be part of that, you just might win something. Now if you're worried about what to get for mom because you might be a bit short on budget, then don't worry. Come on in, check out what CCS can do for you and get something great for mom from Brian Bell this 2017 Mother's Day.
Simply by spending 50 kina or more, you can enter to win the weekly 500 kina cash gift voucher or a grand prize of 1,000 kina gift voucher from Brian Bell. 50 kina gets you 1 entry ticket, 100 kina gets you 2 entry tickets, 250 kina gets you 5 entry tickets, and so forth. You get it, right? So the more you spend, the greater your chances are winning with Brian Bell. And what's even better is that you're eligible with your purchase through CCS. So buy something for mom with CCS and you might just win something extra for her during this Mother's Day with our Mother's Choice competition.
Well, that's all the time we have in this segment of Shopping with Brian Bell. It's been a very informative segment, and I know you've seen that CCS is a great tool you can use to get quality products from Brian Bell. Also, our Mother's Choice competition is running. It started yesterday, the 17th of April, and is running. So be part of that. Shop with Brian Bell, and you might win something extra for your mom during this Mother's Day. And always remember, quality products, great services, and great value. That's Brian Bell. Until our next time together, it's goodbye and God bless.
Hey, hey, Mr. B.
Well, there you have it, Brian Bell's customer credit scheme and Mother's Choice competition, along with simple benefits offered to keep your mind set on your goals for Mother's Day. Always remember, viewers, that when shopping with Brian Bell, with this scheme, you get to obtain quality products, repayment done over a period of time, and it can suit your budget. Margaret joins us on Kolos You're Wearing featuring a very talented jewelry maker. We shall find out after these short messages. Having a certain talent and being extremely good at it is just so amazing, especially when it has a boomerang effect. You know, more like a win-win situation where you create something beautiful and people marvel at it as a result. That is exactly what we'll be checking out on Kolos You're Wearing with Margaret featuring the beautiful jewelry maker.
Hi everyone, I'm Margaret and thanks for joining me on another segment of Kolos You're Wearing. Today I'm very excited to be introducing our guest, Tiana Reimann.
Thank you.
Tiana, welcome to the show.
Thanks for having me.
So on Kolos You're Wearing, we usually explore different styles and ways we can improve the fashion in Papua New Guinea. And a lot of inspiration can be drawn from our rich culture. I'm so glad you're here today to share your story on your company, actually.
Happy to be here.
For our viewers, Tiana has her own jewelry company, Zambila & Co. I've seen some of your pieces actually right here on the table. It's very beautiful. Can you tell me a bit about Zambila and Co, about the business and how it started?
So I started Zambila and Co last year in April, so it's about 1 year old now. But my designs are very colourful. I love integrating very contrasting colours, also along with Papua New Guinean designs, such as the yellows, the reds, the blacks, and the whites. Just similar to the pom-pom styles here. I've incorporated all the colours. Yeah, so these are the pom-pom range, which I have designed those Papua New Guinean designs in there. But I also like doing the contrasting designs, such as the bright oranges and greens, blues, and integrating them with darker colours as well, such as the blacks or whites as well. But all my designs, there's a range of different designs, different colours, and I love incorporating that colour to people to make them feel bold, make them stand out, make them dress up in the environment that they're in as well. I tried to incorporate, some kind of like grass skirt design or paradise design, some fluffy, feathery looking shimmery colours, even the fan design, but I like to incorporate some kind of PNG heritage into the culture, into the earrings as well.
You started about a year ago right now, so how is business actually?
It's really good. Like, most of the people that wear Zambila get stopped on the streets because I ask them, how did you hear about Zambila?
Yeah.
And they said, oh, I was walking in the car park and this lady raced up to me and asked me, where did you get your earrings from? And so most of the business that comes to Zambila is from word of mouth,
right.
And my Zambila lovers, I call them, mm-hmm. Wearing them out in public.
Yeah.
But I do also social media marketing and promote through my own profile on Facebook and Instagram as well.
That's great, yeah.
But it's going well and I want to expand more into New Zealand, around Australia, mm-hmm. Papua New Guinea, mm-hmm. and possibly the US as well with my designs.
Oh wow, that's awesome. Can you tell me a bit about the process of making one of your pieces?
It's a similar process for all of them.
Okay.
So what they do is they wrap one piece of string mm-hmm. through here, through there, so it creates like a, you can't pull it down, for example.
Okay.
And then they weave it in and out with those threading with the threading through the brass. This is brass here. Mm-hmm. So they put the thread here, they push it there, then they pull it down like this, and then they weave
right.
in and out like this.
Wow, so each piece would take a while to
They're very complete. Skilled. It's made by a women's group, but this is their livelihood, so I'd like to support them, and they do it for a living, so they're very skilled, and they're quick in what they do as well. Mm-hmm. A similar process here, fluff cotton, they get the thread, put it through, pull it down, mm-hmm. then they weave each one of those through as well.
Okay. Wow.
And that's a similar process for all of them as well. Mm-hmm. They just, you can weave it in different styles.
Okay.
So I design them on my computer, for example, mm-hmm. or via pen and paper. Mm-hmm. And then I have my contacts through social media. So I message him or her mm-hmm. saying, these are the designs I'd like to have. Is it okay. possible for you to design with these colors? Right. They'll say yes. And then the designs will come. I will take my photos. I do all in-house marketing, trying to implement my marketing skills
course.
My uni degree.
Yes,
and I hang them up in my house and I take photos. I have an online e-commerce website which I just promote them on.
Mm-hmm.
It takes a few hours to take the photos, but the process is easy, but just timely.
Yeah. You spoke to me a bit about the social aspect of Zambilla and about the Bucket of Love project. Can you tell me a bit more about that?
The Bucket of Love project started in 2015 on Valentine's Day. I was pretty lonely that day, but I decided to start this project after I went to a school and they told me they had all these chlorine buckets at their school. Mm-hmm. And so I went to his school and I saw 60 buckets, for example. That's the estimated amount I had. And I said, wow, these buckets could do so much for a village in West New Britain, which is where I come from. And I decided, yes, I'll take those buckets and I'll ship them across with my family's container to West New Britain and see how it goes. But then I incorporated inside the bucket educational items, sporting equipment, or even clothing as well, and health items. And then I'd also try to incorporate Zambilla into it by providing $5 from every earring into the Bucket of Love. And so I ended up raising about $2,000 last year, which went towards towards the shipping cost and towards buying some more sporting equipment or stationery for the schools as well, which they love. I love doing it as well. It's really, really rewarding.
Wow, that's really great. That's so inspirational, actually.
When you have that corporate social responsibility around your business, people are more inclined to help you as well. And it also, it's so rewarding for yourself. And I love doing it. The whole focus about making money isn't what I'm about. It's about making myself a living, but helping my culture along the way as well.
Do you have any advice for people who have this sort of creative fire and they want to start their own company or they want to do their own designs?
Yeah, definitely. I'd really urge any women or men who have craftsman skills, making jewelry or billums, to reach out to people like me who have those connections with international markets like Australia or US. And people that have the marketing skills and the technology to send your products. So for example, reach out to me, I can help you get your product into that market, also provide some income for yourself as well.
As you said, you encourage our viewers who are creative to go ahead and, you know, start their own ideas, don't be afraid, and yeah.
Thank you very much for having me.
Thanks for being here.
What a lovely feature. Something for you ladies out there to check out. The jewels are beautiful and I already want to own a pair. Thanks Margaret for that. Viewers, if you'd like to know more about the Zambilla and Core jewelry makers, check out our Facebook page for links and other relevant information. We'll take a short break. However, if you're in need of information as to where you can get a good and satisfying massage, the Nesian Beauty is back again with more in detail. You're watching House and Home. See you in a bit. Welcome back to the show. Now, I'm sure the long weekend has got you involved in so much activity, probably cleaning up the flower garden or a little bit of carpentry or laundry. Not to worry, it's good to give yourself a special treat and make time available for massage at the Nesian Beauty. That is what we're looking at in the moment, so enjoy.
the numerous stresses and strains that come with the fast-paced city life, it is important to relax and make time for yourself. Our team here at Nesian can help take you through a journey where you will be pampered, feel refreshed and rejuvenated. I'm Louisa at Nesian Beauty and welcome to another segment. This week is a special edition. We will take you through some of the services we provide. Our guest here today is Nicole. She is a young professional here in Port Moresby. You might recognize her as one of our hosts on Haus Home. She has a 45-hour work week, often putting in those overtimes. She is in desperate need of our services. We have invited her here today to go through one of our most requested full body massages. Our therapist has discussed with Nicole her problem areas and the desired outcome of her session. Sitting at the desk for a prolonged period is not good for your spine and your lower back. The muscle often gets tense and sore. This form of massage will start with broad flowing strokes that will help calm the nervous system and relax the exterior muscle tension. The body will become more relaxed. Our therapist will then increase pressure to target the problem areas to relieve areas of the muscle tension. Often we use a variety of grass-bilas body oils and lotions to allow your muscles to be massaged without causing excessive friction to the skin. The oil also hydrates the skin to create a more youthful glow. Massage and bodywork can help release chronic muscular tensions and pain, improve circulation, increase joint flexibility, reduce mental and physical fatigue and stress, promote faster healing for injured muscular tissue, improve posture and reduce blood pressure. Apart from these benefits, it is also known to promote better sleep, improve concentration, reduce anxiety, and create an overall sense of well-being. During the massage, if you feel any discomfort, please let the therapist know. Yeah, Nicole, you look more relaxed. How did you feel after the massage?
I feel actually at ease and I'll say the nice comfort feeling that you have. That's what I'm feeling right now, like so relaxed, and I think I'm going to enjoy today.
How was the process? Did the girls treat you well? Like, were you happy how they did your massage?
Actually enjoyed the way in which they greeted me, and then I told them that I was here for a massage, and they sat me down, had a chat, and wanted to find out what type of massage I needed. I told them that I had like certain back aches and muscle aches after standing long hours out on shoot. After I talked to them, they told me the different types of massage they have. So I asked them to explain which type of massage would be the best. And after explaining, I decided that I needed to go for the deep tissue massage. And right now, I think I'm good because after pressing all those hard blood clots and all that, it feels at ease. Like I feel my body more relaxed than when I walked in here.
Next time, would you recommend to come back for another massage?
Yes, definitely. I would recommend my best friends who are workaholics like me to actually come and have a massage. And Just relax at the salon.
Thank you so much, Nicole.
My pleasure.
That was fantastic. I could see how relieved and relaxed our friend Nicole was. I'm sure no one will ever deny the fact that they need some sort of relaxation and away from noise and so forth. For more information on Nesian Beauty's massage services, feel free to give them a call and they'll be more than happy to assist you. Coming up after the break, we join Dr. Ambi on Healthy Mind, so stay watching.
This is Healthy Mind with Dr. Ambi, proudly brought to you by Telecom PNG Limited.
Welcome to Healthy Mind. Well, happy Easter to all that are straight, because let this year bring you all God's blessing. Now, it's important for us to put God first and learn more things so that we can understand our own life and stay healthy and have good quality of life. So, well, viewers, this evening, meet Thingim Olsem. Plenty old story come up lo paper, nalo kind kind media. We talk about cancer and mental illnesses. Why me to choosing this last topic? Because cancer is one of the issues we have, and a lot of our loved ones have been going through with the diagnosis of cancer, and we lose a lot of our loved ones just because of cancer. And how we treat our loved ones depends on our own mental health and the patient's mental health. So today's topic, we will talk about cancer and mental health. We will focus today on some of the facts which is important for you and I to understand better, so that we have better idea and better knowledge about cancer and why that mental health is important when we suffer cancer, or even ourselves as a family members who are looking after the cancer patients. Is very important to look good through law. I belong all, now understand him all. Now, sample of facts you may must look. Number one fact is approximately half of all patients with terminal or advanced cancer suffer with poor mental health, specifically depression, anxiety, adjustment disorder. It plagues through with the people with the advanced on terminal cancer. Now, while half of the terminally ill person, that means with cancer, and advanced cancer patient suffer from depression and anxiety and adjustment disorder, and less than half of the cancer patients actually receive treatment for mental health. Emi fact through or semi law, you may no stop law here law frighten me blah, but we have to understand it so that we can make a better change in our way of thinking to look after our loved ones. So M1 blah point you may talk. Number 2 point, death rates you may look him is much higher, like 25% higher in cancer patients who felt depressed, and 39% higher in the patients who have been diagnosed with the depression. So, or those who have received medicine for depression. So you will see depression, because our World Health Day, we know that the whole month we were going to talk about the World Health Day, the topic is depression, let's talk. So we have to know these some facts that depression is associated with cancer. Number 3 point is the depression is a disabling illness and affects about 15 to 25% cancer patient. It affects men and women in the cancer, whoever having cancer, equally. Number 4 point, the relationship between cancer and depression is complex. So depression may be triggered, okay, when somebody is diagnosed with cancer, or other issues related to the cancer and its treatment, okay, and also the impact of cancer and also in the person's life. So you will see that depression is also associated with all these areas when there is a diagnosis of cancer. However, depression may occur by the chance to be related to some other difficult events, and also either in the past or present issues also can create this problem, which have nothing to do with cancer. Something wrong, Loman, and can create him this like depression, and there is cancer. They're all like our same brother, na sister. Number 5 point is cancer, especially breast cancer and lung cancer, you will see, are the second most common cause of death. Even here, cervical cancer, breast cancer, now Olgata. Now, in people with schizophrenia, so we are not only talking about normal people who have been diagnosed with cancer, have got depression, but we also talk about patients who have been diagnosed as schizophrenia or mental health issue as a mental health person, and they also can develop cancer, and that also can lead to the depression as they recognize. So you will see that risk for cancer death is 50% higher than of the general population, because we don't pick up or we don't diagnose, hurry up. Suppose somebody, your loved one, has got mental health issue and they don't go to doctor early. So by the time they find out, it's too late. So that also have a big impact and on the mental health and cancer. And schizophrenic patients, they don't get much benefit from optimum treatment because mental health issue is the primary cause, and less compliance with the treatment. And also people who always feel hurry up, suppose you got mental health issue prior to diagnosis of cancer. Number 6 point, adequate recognition and treatment of depression in patients with cancer can enhance the quality of life and help patients and families to make the best use of their remaining time together. And since patients are often reluctant to describe their depressive symptoms, caregiver, that means you as a family member, need to know how depression can be recognized. I think it's very, very important that cancer and mental illness, we find that Michigan, University of Michigan, and kind law all sampla research all walking law America, all pining all same. Suppose symptoms can include like awesome lack of sleep, lack of interest in things, about generally in life, anxiety, irritation, old lack of loss of concentration, and also severe the thought of suicide, or some change in the pattern of sleeping and eating pattern, and also loss of energy. Now suppose you pine him, it is important for family members to think, our relatives or a loved one who has been diagnosed with like cancer, are they having these symptoms? And it is important for the patients to get proper and appropriate help so that they can improve their quality of life. And one of the doctors, working research law, psycho-oncology, that means psychiatry, and then the oncology law, cancer, all pinemosim, often patients tell that dealing with the emotions of cancer is actually harder than coping with the medical problem itself. So the doctors also pinem, dealing with the emotions emotional problems among the patients are harder than dealing with the medical problem itself. So it is important for us today, critically it is important for us today, to get our things and thoughts together, diagnose depression early and treat any mental health issues in relation to cancer. Well, viewers, you know something, that is cancer and mental illness or mental health issues are common. And this World Health Day, I want to say depression, let's talk. I want to dedicate this to the people who have been going through emotional issues in relation to after diagnosing cancer or the family members. Let this time, your time, to think about how we can help our loved ones to stay and have quality of life.
Healthy Mind was proudly brought to you by Telecom PNG Limited.
Hey everybody, and welcome to Home Habits. How was your Easter weekend? Oh, mine was great. I just stayed in and did absolutely nothing. Actually, no, that's a lie. I went to work. Yeah. But anyway, in the spirit of true Easter, I'm going to show you all how to make something tall, dark, and sweet. Well, it's kind of tall. It's definitely dark and sweet. All right, so first things first. To start, we're going to add some water to the pot. Just about an inch or so, not too much, just enough so that it covers the bottom and it doesn't touch the bowl when you put it in. Okay. All right, now we just leave that on to boil. So the next step is to take your chocolate and chop it up. Be sure to chop the chocolate up into fine pieces, not too fine, just chunks that can be easily melted. There we go. Like so. It's just like chopping up capsicum, I swear. Nice. All right, now all that our chocolate is chopped up. Ooh, okay. Our pot has definitely reached boiling capacity. Now we just need to put the chocolate into the bowl and then place it over the pot. Don't start smoking it. That's what she said. She said we're dressed in black, head to toe. We're gonna sit on a rock. We're never gonna quit, no, we're never gonna quit, no. Now we just leave that to boil for a bit. And we occasionally come back to stir it. That looks divine. Alrighty, I think we're pretty much done now. You can see inside that there's still a couple of little chunks left of chocolate, but that's a good thing. I've just switched the heat off, so right now I can take off the bowl and put it onto the chopping board so that the residual heat from the bowl and the already melted chocolate we'll just finish off the tiny bits of chocolate that are inside. All right, so let's grab this pot off the heat, eh? Oh, nice. I'm a pro. Okay. Whew, that is hot. Now we just keep stirring it because we don't want it to solidify anytime soon. We just get rid of those little chunks of chocolate that are left inside. Yeah. So, just to make the next step a little easier, I'm gonna have to pour the chocolate into this measuring jug. That'll make sure that when I pour it into the little Coke bottle, it's a lot easier and we don't get mess everywhere. Okay. Alrighty, so we've got the dark checked, we've got the sweet checked, and pretty soon we're gonna have the tall checked as well. Now the next step, since we gotta work fast before our chocolate starts to freeze up, is to pour it, finally, into our Coke bottle. Alright, so let's do this. When you pour it in, you're gonna wanna stop when you reach about a third of the way. So right around there. Then, here's the tricky part. You gotta roll the chocolate around so then it covers every last bit of the bottle. And now comes the super, super fun bit. We get to wait for the chocolate to freeze. All you have to do is just put this in the fridge for about an hour and then come back when it's solid enough. Then you just cut out the plastic to remove it. All right. Alrighty, if I can just, nice. And there we have it. So I guess this bit is just optional. If you want to put stuff inside of it, you can. You can put M&Ms, jelly beans, or pretty much anything you want. But since I love peanuts, I'm gonna go with some peanuts. All right. And it's done. Now I'm gonna head upstairs and share the magic of Easter with everyone. Let's go. It's so good, right?
Yes, it is so good. You have to give me the recipe. Oh my God, this is so good. I wonder how long it took though.
It's really simple. It just took an hour to freeze and then it took like 30 minutes to put the whole thing together. Just watch Home Habits. You'll understand.
I am totally watching this. I'm not missing out because I want this. Good job, Godfrey.
Thanks, Billy. Happy Easter. No. I'm gonna have to give to people. Come on, Billy. What do you think? Have more than that. Come on.
Really?
Yeah, sure. Oh, hey, whoa. Okay. Hey, whoa.
Can I try some peanuts?
Yeah, sure. If you want to learn how to make one of these, just tune into Home Habits. Yeah, House and Home.
Will do.
Nice.
Thank you.
Awesome. Happy Easter.
Happy Easter.
Awesome. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is how you make a chocolate Coke bottle and get everyone in your office to like you. For more awesome DIY projects, keep watching House and Home.
Anyway, we've come to the end of our show. It's been a great pleasure having your company, and I hope you've picked out a thing or two in this week's collection of household tips and stories. Furthermore, do check out our Facebook page for updates and let us know what you think and what you'd like to see more of in the coming episodes. If you'd like to catch up on the previous editions, please visit MTV online. I'm Thursday Miria. Be sure to join us next week, same time, for more tips and ideas on home and lifestyle improvement. On behalf of the House and Home team, pleasant viewing, take care, and enjoy the rest of the week.
Improving lifestyle. It's all about the better.